So allow your lower back to start to relax on the floor, lengthening the back of the neck. Yeah, so take a little time here to, you ground your calf, your whole, the whole of your calf on the chair, okay? And ground your hips and then start to move to spread your body as much as you can in this moment. You're not forcing, just wherever you can, just now. And then start to settle. And just for a few breaths, just allow your body to connect with the mat, with the position, with the chair. And then focusing more on your breath now. If it's possible, the only change is to try to breathe in through your nose, if it's possible. If not, at least the breathing through your nose. And then if you have to breathe out through your mouth, that's okay. Yeah? Now, when you breathe in, imagine that you are taking an impulse, a soft impulse with your body, and on the breathe out, allow your body to surrender more and more to the floor. Yeah? So you take your breath and then connect on the breathe out. So the whole back of your body that is touching the floor and the back of the legs touching the chair, imagine that in each breathe out, you are connecting more your body to the mat. And in that falling down into the floor, imagine that you are trespassing or the floor or the mat, or you are connecting with those roots that we always imagine beneath, coming from your body or already on the floor, and you connect more your roots on the ground, or you connect yourself more with the roots that are already there. Okay? So just dedicate this breath just to feel that connection, to imagine that connection. Yeah, that those roots are beneath you, starting to open a channel between you and the planet. And through those roots, you can start to receive the energy of the planet, but also you are allowing yourself to relax and to release the tension that you carry into the roots to be recycled. Okay? So again, imagine now the whole process. When you breathe in, you take an impulse, and on the breathe out, you surrender, you go down into the roots, into the floor, to soften, to flatten, to disappear even in the roots, to get that sensation of being cleansed and purified. And if you like, you can add in this equation the idea of having around you a beautiful loving energy. You can use, remember, the color pink for this energy, a loving, caring energy. So you are breathing the light and the energy, and that energy is helping you to relax more, to spread more, so the roots can take more of the tension and the tightness or any pain that you are carrying. Also, we can use the white light of the clouds that we have at the moment. So the white light is also purifying. Yeah? So imagine the white light and the pink light as you breathe in, helping yourself to open and to send that energy in, and then that same energy is finding all the spots of tension and stress, and is helping you to release it to the roots, to be dissolved, to be recycled. Yeah? So with all that in mind, yeah? So imagine you set this process. It's like you are aware of this process. So now you have that process in motion. Yeah, it's happen every time that you breathe. Yeah, with every breath, you are doing that cleansing. Yeah, so when we add the movement, it's like we are helping with the movement to direct the energy to the different areas of our body. Yeah, so it's not only the physical aspect that we are working the whole self, yeah, the emotional and all the mind aspect as well, and the stressful things that we are carrying at the moment. Yeah, so with this in mind, yeah, we will catch one leg to your belly. We catch the knee. Yeah, we soften. Now, don't force. Yeah, just allow the leg to go to your belly. Relax your elbows. Relax your neck, the back of the neck, nice and open. Soften. Yeah? And again, each breathe out, imagine that you are opening more your lower back. Keep lengthening the spine and keep imagining that you are spreading your back, like a widening your back toward the sides of your body as well. Then we will open the knee to the side. We catch the foot. Yeah? We soften again your arms, relaxing, bringing the leg closer without forcing it. And then we put the foot over the leg. And in that position, we keep the other leg on the chair. And try to press with your back now into the floor, pressing your shoulder blades, even pressing the arms on the floor, the back of your arms, lengthening the back of the neck. And do a little effort here to press your body into the mat, lengthening, expanding, widening. Very nice. And from there, we will move in this position towards you. We can lift in the second leg from the chair and we roll side to side. Soften. Really gentle, yeah? So we soften, trying to keep that back nice and expanding on the floor. And then we change. We put that leg on the chair and we take the other knee. So try to keep your back more and more expanding on the floor with each position. Shoulders away, elbows relaxing, lengthening. And then we open the knee to the side, soften, relax, shoulders away. And then put the foot on the leg and press now with your back into the floor. Yeah? With the same idea of the breathing before. When you breathe in, take an impulse and then press your body into the floor, connecting more, expanding more. And trying to keep this connection, we bring the legs and we soften side to side. Now, we will put again the leg on the chair and we will extend this leg up now. Nice and soft. Remember the knee is not tensing, yes, soft. And we move the leg side to side, but keeping that connection with your back there, softening. and then circles. Doesn't need to be strong or fast, yeah, nice and soft. And then the opposite direction. And then we move the foot in circle. And then the opposite direction. And then flexing and stretching. Go. And the toes squeezing. Very nice. We put that leg back. We stretch the other one. And softening side to side. Really gently. So we keep expanding your back. Yeah? That's why we stay a long time on the back, because staying on the back with the legs bending, that the lower back is nice and connected on the floor, is the best way to stretch your spine and your back. Yeah, it's the safest way. And by time, yeah, the gravity force is helping you to expand. Yeah, so if we only stay on the floor every day, like a 5 minutes will be okay, yeah, our back. And then we move the foot in circles. And then the opposite direction. And flexing and stretching. Go. Well done. And then we bring both legs and we roll. Side to side, feeling the whole back. Yeah, remember the shoulder blades when we do these movements, touching the floor. Yeah, good. And then we roll toward one side, and we go to face the front. Good. So shoulders away. Yeah, remember always the shoulders away from your ears with a nice space. And we move the hips in circles. And then the opposite direction. Good. And then on the center, relax your back. Yeah? So not forcing the lower back, just relax your belly, relax your lower back, shoulders away, head up. Just let your belly soft and let the spine accommodate in that position. Yeah? And then to round, we will try to lift in the lower back up. And then we will squeeze the lower part of your belly, like the part that is on your pubic bone. Let's say, squeeze that part in a little bit to help this rounding. We are working on the pelvic floor as well, yeah? So breathing, expanding open, softening, completing the whole arching of the spine, not in a forcing way. And then rounding, lifting lower back as well, squeezing the lower belly, head and neck relax. Your shoulders are away from your ears. And again, expanding. And one more time. Good. Now we curl the toes. We put the back of the toes on the floor. Connecting, open. And the same. Squeeze now the toes and rounding, squeezing the lower belly. And again, opening. And squeeze. Well done. And we go to child pose. So we put the knees, the floor back with your hips. We soften, yeah, we relax your neck and your head. Shoulders away. And let go completely. Relax. soft. Keep the idea of that surrendering, that action of the breathe out to bring you nice and down, connecting with the roots, with that opening, that channeling of energy to cleanse you, to purify you, and to bring nourishment with the energies of the planet. And remember that all around you, you have that cocoon of pink light, pink energy, the energy of unconditional love, the energy of caring. So imagine surrounding yourself with that light to give you a nice feeling of being loved, protected, minded. And then we move the hands to one side a little bit. Soften your shoulders and elbows so you can relax deeply your upper body. And then we go to the other side. Relax. Now we're coming back to the center. We will put the hands on the chair now. So more or less the separation that allows you to have the arms stretching, but remember not tensing. Yeah? Still the position of the shoulders are relaxing away from your ears, okay? So nice and comfy there. We will put the position and then we will bring one arm on the mat, yes, so we keep one. And we soften there on the center. So the hips are going back, your belly and your chest, your solar plexus is going toward the floor, but your arm is soft, so we are not tensing it. We keep the stretching, but not forcing it, yeah? Softening with your breathing. And then change, put that arm on the mat, and we put the other hand on the chair, and we relax that side. Soft, not forcing, okay? So check a position that is okay. And then relax. We go to all fours and we will relax the shoulder blade now on the back. Yeah? So we bring the arm beneath, we put the shoulder, we put the head, we stretch the other arm, softening, try to have the elbow on the floor if it's possible. So again, your upper body is trying to relax toward the arm that is on the floor. It's like the hips are up, but the front, the body, the upper body is like a child pose. Yeah? The sensation of relaxing down to the floor. The only difference is that we have the arm there and the bum is up. But the sensation, yeah, the feeling, imagine that you want to get the feeling of the child pose. Relaxing and surrendering to the floor. And then relax. We go with the other arm. So we soften the shoulder away. We put the head on the floor, nice and comfy. And we relax. Softening deeply. And then relax, coming back. Good. Now we will go to all fours again and we will work with one leg. Okay? So shoulders again away from your ears. Open the leg back. Relax your, again, your belly and your lower back. Okay, open. And then when we round, we try to round deeply. Again, squeezing the lower belly here. Bringing the chin like toward the head and the head toward the knee. And then expand. I think I say it wrong. So, knee to the head and head to the knee. That's what I meant. Breathing, expanding shoulders away, arching softly. So we don't rush the arching. So you really feel your spine. Yeah, we want to be able to feel every single movement. That's why we go slowly. One more time. And again. Good. Now, stay with the leg extending back. The toes pointing down. Yes, so your heel is pushing back. Now, we will work again with that sensation of the lower back. Same leg, yeah? So, we try to lift in the lower back and engage in the belly a little bit. Not too stiff, yeah? And then relax the lower back, okay? So, we lift in the lower back up. And then relax your belly and your lower back. It's not hard, it's not pushing hard, it's not fast. It's a little bit that you bring the awareness to the position and the feeling, and then relax. Yeah, it's really a gentle movement. One more time. Lifting, lengthening from the crown of the head to the heel. And relax. Good. We will go with the other leg. So nice and open, expanding shoulders away, and then rounding, trying to bring the head toward the knee. That's the direction. Eh? We don't touch. So we're expanding. And then rounding. Softly. Yeah? But remember, when you round, you try to squeeze the lower belly. In that way, we are working on the core, and also we are working on the pelvic floor that we all need it. Yeah. Good. And then stretch your leg back, point with the toes down, so your heel is pushing back, pushing with your hands, your shoulders are away, and again, lifting the lower back a tiny bit, so you feel this is straight, and then relax. Lifting. Engaging lower belly. When you engage, try to feel that you are engaging that part, that you are not tensing the rest of your body, just the lower back. We are bringing awareness to the area to know when we are tensing or when we are releasing, and also we are strengthening. Okay? One more time. Ah, relax, well done. We put the hands on the chair. We move the hips forward here. Yeah. So, foot nice and open. Try to lift in the toes from the floor. Yeah. And then put the whole of the sole of your foot, not the arch. Yeah. So, the ball, the outside part, and the heel. And then press your toes toward the floor, expanding it. Yeah. So, take a moment to feel your foot there. And then you go with the rest of the weight of your body there. But you are nice and grounding. Yeah? Shoulders away. We want to feel all the time that you are really connected with the floor. So you feel that your roots are still working to bring you the energy and you are releasing the tension. Yeah? Cool. So we will go back a little bit. Hips rotating out. Expanding back, we don't tense the leg. Even if you can, don't bring the knee down like that, yeah? So slowly. And then we go heel, sole of your foot, ball of the foot, toes. And then we relax the weight of your body and we lengthen the back of the neck and the spine. And then we go hips out. We stretch back nice and soft, and no forcing, whatever is okay. And we go heel, sole of your foot, ball of your foot, toes nice and open. Relax the weight of your body on the floor. And one more time back, yeah? Remember when we work on the sole of our feet, we are working the rest of the body, yeah? We will go to the other side. Here we have like a map of the body on the sole of your feet. Yeah? So we go heel, sole of your foot, ball of your foot, toes, and then boom, relaxing. Shoulders away, we are not touching, yeah? We are lengthening up, not tensing, relaxing. And then heel, hips out, spread back wherever is possible. And again, heel, expanding, open, spread, and then back, yeah? One more time. Well done, very nice. Good, so from there we will put the arms on the chair, hands or elbows, yeah? And we go to forward bend here. So check that you have, again, the sole of your feet nice and open. So again, lifting your toes from the floor, spread your toes and then boom, engage your feet. And check that your knees are not extending and not too bending. So depending of the height, put pillows or bolsters or cushions or blocks if you need to feel comfortable, okay? And try to relax on the chair, keeping part of the grounding. So your hips are above your heels, yeah? So you keep your hips on the heels and the rest of your body on the chair. And imagine that channel of energy of the roots coming, sending energy to your feet. And imagine the energy is passing through your legs, your lower back, your spine, your back, your shoulders, your neck, your head, your arms. And it's cleansing you of all the tension, all the tightness, all the stiffness, pain, discomfort. Yeah? Let go, relax, surrender. Take your time, yes? So let your body, give the body time. Don't rush it so you can really start to feel the release. And then slowly coming up. We put the hands on the chair. We look up, shoulders away. Yeah. Now, nice and comfy, yeah? We will do a little bit of what we did with the legs, yeah? So, but really gentle, okay? So relax your belly and arch a little bit the lower back, and then lift in the lower back. Don't go into full rounding, yeah? Just a little bit. So a little bit of lifting the lower back, and then relaxing your hips out. Because sometimes that's where we don't have the awareness on the small movements. And it's there where we can find the release, yeah, the real release. So that you know that you are open, and then you know when you are tensing even a little, yeah? So relax. It's really tiny, the movement, yeah? And then we bring the weight into the legs. Pressing into the feet, again, your toes nice and open, expanding. And spreading, yeah, shoulders away. Remember the knees soft, yeah, don't tense your knees. We lift in the arms and we expand softly. Now try to keep that sensation of the foot. We will do a little bit of grounding, standing, because I think it's a good work to do grounding before tomorrow that is open everything. So when we go out, we feel strong and supported and protected. Yeah? So we will go expanding back on the side. The knees are not tensing, yeah? Soft, shoulders away. And then do a little bit of bending. Spread your toes, lifting the toes. Yeah? And then you press and you expand. Without going into tension, it's like you're lifting the energy from beneath and you spread it through your body. Yeah? So you yield into the floor and then expanding and open. And then we go to the other side. So first, a nice soft stretch, shoulders away. And then bending, lifting the toes, feel the ball of your foot here. Yeah? And then pressing, 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 expand. And one more time. Yeah? And spread. And then coming back. Good. Relax. Well done. Very nice. So we turn the chair around to have the back of the chair facing you. Good. We will start with a little bit of going up and down on the toes, yeah, before we do a stretching. So with the same idea, so try to spread the sole of your feet and go into the toes, yeah? Shoulders are relaxed. So really spread your toes, the ball of your foot. On the ball of the foot, we have the major organs of the body. So when we press that, when we spread, it's like we give release to everything, brain, lungs, heart, all the big organs are there. Yeah. So imagine that you're massaging that. That's what we do when we do a reflexology class. Yeah. So when we go down here, we will try to roll toward your feet until we arrive to the heels, and then you lift in the toes again. Yeah. And then again, open toes, go into the toes, spread shoulders away. And then rolling, 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 rolling. Heels on the floor, toes up. So we do two or three. It's just to get this idea of that the feet are open to that channel of the roots, yeah? Just visualizing that you are open those doors, yeah? Or that window or that gate into the energy, direct energy of the planet, yeah? One more time. And also the sensation that you are fully grounded, fully protected. We will stay on the toes one more time. Stay there, lengthen into the crown of your head, shoulders away, stay a little bit there. Engage belly, engage a little bit your glutes, and we lengthen everything up, yeah? And then relax, release. Well done. So we will move the hips out now, your knees bending. We will go to this stretch that we normally do. But again, when you start to go back, feel for a moment the toes up, engage the heels, the ball of your feet, and then spread your toes, and then relax the front of your body, your belly, your chest. Shoulders are relaxing away from your ears, and go back with your hips, yeah? Open the sole of your feet on the floor, your toes. So we will breathe in up, a little bit up, and then back, hips, back, chest over the floor. Breathing open, soften back, softly, softly, softly. Yeah, we want to feel the breath. We want to feel every single little movement that the body does. So you are in control, you are in full awareness of your body. Good. Well done. And then we soften. We will put one leg forward and one leg back. Comfy, not in line because it's difficult to keep the balance. Yeah? Comfy, not too separated. Yeah. So with the knees soft first, move the hips out and we go to the same position. So you check here. If we can extend the legs, we extend it. Again, not tense in your knees always soft. If not, you can bend a little bit to accommodate the hips, yeah? So depending how you feel on the hips, you extend the legs, not tensing, or you bend the legs a little. Shoulders away. Spread, you can move a little bit side to side here. And then again we do, breathing a little bit up and soften, hips out. Bend the knees if you need to free your hips and your back, okay? Don't tense the legs. Soften. One more time. And soften back. And then we put the back foot. Where is the front foot? We bring the other leg back. Again, hips out. Move slowly. Check your knees. Yeah. This has to be as much comfortable as you can. Yeah. You can bend the legs or extend them without tensing. Yeah. Soft. And again, go back, move hips side to side, shoulders are away. And then breathing open, breathe out, relaxing. Breathing open, breathe out, relaxing. One more time. And relax. Well done. And then we move both legs, the last stretch here, with both hips at the same time. And then rounding slowly, walking forward. And spread your shoulders away. We will just turn around. We will do a nice open later on the floor. Yeah? So don't worry, we will sort this part as well. So shoulders away. Again, lifting your toes, feel your heels, feel the ball of your foot, spread your toes. And when you feel that connection, press. Imagine that you are pressing into the root, like when you press the accelerator of the car, yeah, the gas. And imagine when you do that, you are absorbing energy from the planet. So you prepare, you press, and then expanding, letting the energy flow up. Shoulders away, nice and connected here, hips tilting forward. Okay, and we will put the hands on the chair. If the chair is too low for you, you can put your hands on your bum or your legs. Yeah. Shoulders, remember the shoulders are away from your ears and that space here. Yeah. So hips tilting forward, yeah, doing the muffin top here. Check, 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 and expand, but not tensing, soft. Yeah? The tension, the strong part is that the feet pushing to receive that energy up. Yeah? And then relax, release, well done. We will sit in on the chair, okay? So, nice and comfy there. Remember, we sit in, not too much on the back of the chair, more on the front, your feet nice and grounded, shoulders away. Yeah? So pressing into the hips, lifting, expanding solar plexus chest with the shoulders away. Yeah? So relax. Remember, this position is really important if you are working at home or in the office. Hours on the computer, yes. Yeah? So always, as much as you can, don't lean into the chair. Always try to be on your hips. That will keep your spine nice and long and strong, yeah? Don't rely too much on the back of the chair, as much as you can. Yeah? Shoulders away, yeah? We will open the arms, soften shoulders. We will spread up. Just a couple of movements here. Trying to keep the shoulders away, yeah? Good. Soft. Check that we are not into tension, eh? Just to free the shoulders. We will go with one more. Very nice. Relaxing. And then in the next one, we will stay with one. Shoulders away. And we will move in this position. Soft, yes, yeah? So we are not tensing, it's really gentle and soft. Yeah? So you notice all the tension that we carry there. In the next one, we will stay and we will relax this arm back. We can put it on the leg or falling or catching the chair, whatever is you prefer, depending on the length of the arm. And this hand, we will take the head on the side. So the spine is straight up, your chest is lifted, and we relax the head to stretch this area, yeah? So here you decide if you keep it with the hand here or low or on the chair. There is no tension here, just the tension that you have, not adding, that's what I meant, sorry. Spread. Now coming back, yeah? We will expand the arm up. We will expand the other arm, shoulders away. We will put the hand out behind your back, yeah? Shoulder again. Rotate it back with that space, yeah? We will put the other hand, we expand. Again, pushing into the hips, lengthening the spine. So this part is nice and strong, but this part is soft, the upper back, the shoulder blades. Expanding wherever is possible. Shoulder away, yeah? Breathe. And then really, really softly, the hand that is up is coming again on the side of the head, and we stretch your neck back there. We are not forcing it, eh? It's just the hand, the weight of your arm, moving the head, not fully, not forcing it, yeah? It's the weight. And then relax. We will change softly. We will go to the other arm. So the arm, or on the leg, or falling, or on the chair. The arm softly here. First we catch the head. Soft, yeah? Really gentle, take your time, don't rush it, because this part was already stretched, so really gentle. The beauty of work really gentle and soft is that you bring the awareness. So then in your normal life, you can realize, you can feel when your body is about to snap, or when you are forcing, when you are tensing, yeah? You can really read the signals of your body. You can really feel it. So you will avoid a lot of the extra tension that we create, or the injuries, sometimes the small injuries that are there, the ones that make our life uncomfortable. Yeah. So when we bring awareness, you will catch it before it goes worse. Then we relax, yeah? Now we expand again, keeping that softness. We will put the hand behind, the other hand behind. Remember the shoulder. This is a more important part in this position, the shoulder back and away. That space, we don't want to stretch in this position, yeah? Expand. Spread, spread. Shoulders away. Lengthen your spine. And then we catch the side again of the head, and we soften in this position. We keep that shoulder rotate. It's really gentle and soft. And then release. Now, soften for a moment. We will put both hands now behind your head, again with the shoulders away. Now, hips are pushing, so your spine is straight. So this part is nice and long. Your belly is connected to support it. Yeah? Not tensing, yeah? Just the hips and this part. Yeah? So this part is soft. And without rounding your back, this is really important in this one, we keep the chest lifted. We bring the chin toward the chest. So you are not rounding your back. Yeah, it's just the head only. So you keep that lengthening of the spine. Only the chin toward the chest. As much as you can, keep the lengthening of the spine. So you will start to feel like a line across your spine. That is like a sensation that you are lengthening that part. Keep pressing with your hips into the chair, so you keep lengthening the spine. Only you are bringing the chin toward the chest. Your spine is lifted. Good. Now we will open the elbows. Shoulders again are away. Check that you are not tensing it. So we roll We bring the elbows close. We bring the chin again toward the chest. Not the whole spine, just the chin, just the neck. The spine is straight. I'm breathing open. Open elbows, open chest. Stretch more your spine, and again, only your head, only your head. So you will feel the stretch on the neck, pure on the neck. And one more time. Open. Keep the spine super straight, yes? Yeah? So that's your effort there. Keeping the spine straight. One more time, only the head, only the head. But you will feel a nice stretch on along the spine. Yeah? And then relax. Release, expand your arms. Shoulders away, spread and soften. Put the hands, the palms of your hands facing up, your shoulders are relaxed. Try to keep the extension of your spine, the head soft, and just breathe for a moment. You can imagine here the energy coming, or from your feet going up, or you can imagine that you breathe from the crown of your head or from above, and the energy is passing down through your body, taking all that tension that you felt when you were working on those, on the shoulders, and you are sending all that through your body, through your feet, into the roots to be recycled. Also, if it's possible, imagine that you are breathing through your hands as well, through the palms of your hands open. Imagine that you have or lungs or noses or mouths on your hands, that you are opening your hands for the breathing. Little by little, with this practice, you will start to feel on your hands like an energy field. And it's a real, real energy. That is the energy that when we go to a healing practitioner, the healing, hands-on healing that they use, is that energy, this energy, and we all have it. It's just to bring awareness that we have it. So I want you, you have it too, that you can use it for yourself as well, and that you are in charge, in command of the energies around you. Well done, and then relax. Very nice. This practice, you can do it at any moment during the day, just to ground or just to feel, to recharge. Yeah. Even when you are working in the computer, just take 2 minutes and you are, imagine that you are absorbing energy from the hands. Now we will go to the floor. Now have, if you have a block, you use a block, if not a cushion or a pillow. We will do a nice release for the lower back. I will do it with a pillow. I have a block, but I will do it with a pillow so you see that it's possible, okay? So if it's a flat pillow, double, so you have a nice stick. Yeah. Doesn't have to be too high, but that it, you feel that you will be separate from the floor, yeah? Okay, so we will lie down on the floor. Yeah. Nice and comfy. So we will take a moment just to spread. Put your block. You can use also your bolster beneath, yeah? Whatever you have. You put it beneath your hips. Yeah? We will do a nice stretch for the back and for the legs as well. So the pillow or the block is beneath your hips, yeah? As always, like on the sacrum bone, yeah? The triangular bone between the hips. So, taking your time there, check that you are balanced. Now we start to put the hands on the head like we did before, yeah? Imagine that you were about to do an abdominal, yeah? We bring the head up and we try to spread your back on the floor. Lengthening and then trying to put the back of the neck so the chin is toward your chest or toward the base of your neck, yeah? And then expand, yeah? So we want to start with a really nice long spine. And through the movement, we will try to keep that lengthening, eh? You will be able to lengthen and spread more. So every now and then, remember to keep expanding. Then bring your arms up and do a little bit of movement also with the shoulder blades, trying to imagine that you want to separate the shoulder blades from each other and feel the spine on the floor between the shoulder blades. And then relax. So we will working on the lower back now. Bring the belly a little bit in, not tensing it. It's just moving the hips like a tilting forward, the belly in, trying to bring the lower back toward the floor. So you won't be able to put the lower back on the floor because you have the pillow. But imagine that you want to touch the lower back. Yeah? Bring the belly in, keep lengthening your spine. Relax your arms. And just relax there. So as your body falls into the floor, you keep expanding your spine, but into relaxation. Yeah? So here you can bring that idea of the breathing, offering you like a little impulse for then on the breath out to fall into the mat, into the floor, into the ground, into the roots. So the roots are opening to receive all of your tension, your tightness, your stress, your worries, everything that could be bothering you, physical or emotional. Imagine that you are opening your hips and your lower back, that is the center of the emotional body, to let all go into the toes, or into the roots. To be recycled. Imagine those roots giving you all the different kind of energy that you could need. Relaxation, peace, comfort, strength, resilience, fire. Yeah, the strong energy. So anything and everything, imagine that you receive it from the planet. Imagine the planet has all the resources that you will ever need. And you can receive it directly through the image of the roots. As you relax, you let go and you receive. Well. We will bring one knee toward your belly. Nice and comfy. So you can catch your leg or you can keep the arm soft. You check. The leg is going toward your belly to keep expanding the lower back toward the floor. Your arms are relaxing, the back of the neck is long. So you decide here, depending how you feel. If you prefer catching the leg or expanding your arms. Letting go. So the sensation is that you are rounding into the floor, but in fact you are extending and lengthening your spine, freeing your spine of all the tension and the stress that we carry. And then we relax that leg and we bring the other knee. Soften. Relaxing your elbows, relaxing your shoulders. Now we will stretch if you feel the leg up, nice and comfy, eh? No forcing. You can place your arms again here on the side, or you can catch the pillow to feel secure, to try to bring the other leg as well. Yeah? So, comfy, the legs bending as much as you need. You keep falling Now, if this position is not comfortable, you can lower both legs, or we can also bring the knees like to your belly bows. And again, here you can choose if you want to stay in this position with your arms, if you want to catch the legs, or you want to stretch your legs. Yeah? Try to go with the feeling, because sometimes you feel that you want to do a little ball there. For example, yesterday I did this position and I felt that I needed to be with the legs up. And today, no, today I feel that I need to bend the legs. So you go with your feeling. Always listen to your body. Soften the lower back, soften the middle back, the upper back, your shoulders, soften your legs. Then really gentle, really gentle. We will go. If you have the legs extending, you bend the legs and try to put one leg first on the floor. Don't rush it. Once you put the foot, go slowly with the other leg. Try not to arch the lower back. Yeah? Softer. Good. Now, if you feel here, you can walk your feet a little bit forward because this is low, will be okay. Don't go into full extension if you feel that you are starting to arch. Yeah? So wherever is comfortable to keep the same relaxation on the lower back and just opening a little bit your groins here. Yeah? Feel your body. And then coming back. And we will take slowly the pillow. When we put the hips on the floor, don't lift the legs. Keep the legs on the floor, the feet on the floor. Yeah? So we take the pillow and just allow your lower back to relax there. Just don't move too much. Just stay there. Let your body adapt to the flat position. Now, when we do this movement, we always can feel or a hot sensation on your spine or a cold sensation on your lower back. Yeah? Remember, that's okay. That's the nervous system there, that we have a lot of nerves crossing in that area. Because of the deep stretch, we give a space for the muscles to release, and that create a space for the nerves to have a space to move, to act, yeah, to recover the full function. And that's why you feel the sensation. And that release will bring release to all the different areas of your body where the nerves go, the legs, the hips, the arms. Now, without moving too much, enough just to feel comfortable, you can bring you can move the hips a tiny bit to one side and go into a spinal twist, really gentle. Try not to do sharp movement here, yeah? So we keep that relaxation. We relax, we spread, shoulders away, softening. And then to the other side. We spread. Taking your time. And then coming back to the center. And we will go to Shavasana. Yeah? Trying to keep that sensation. Yeah? So nice and comfy. You can put your blanket if you need. You can put your pillows beneath your knees. Yeah? And take your time. So visualize again your roots beneath, all the planet beneath you. Imagine above you that pink light, yeah, the loving, caring, protective light. Plus, if you like to keep working with the white light. And imagine that we will create, we will form like a unit of all those energies, yeah, all the energies from the planet, plus the lights, the pink and the white. And imagine that we will form one energy, one beam or stream of energy, and that energy is the one that will enter into your feet and will provide you with all the qualities that you need as you relax deeply yourself. So imagine this energy already there on the sole of your feet, moving through the toes, the top of your feet, your ankles, your lower legs, your knees, your thighs and your hips, your lower back, middle back, upper back, shoulder blades. Imagine that energy moving through your shoulders, through your arms, your hands, your fingers, through your wrists, elbows, shoulders, the back of your neck, the back of your head, the crown of your head and your face, your neck, your chest, your belly, allowing your body to surrender completely to the floor and going deeply inside now and relax, relax, relax. Slowly, really slowly, allow your awareness to get back to your body and start to bring some movements to your hands, to your feet, moving your fingers, your toes, moving your head side to side, and bringing your arms back and lengthen and stretch. And from there we go to one side, bending your knees. And we go to a sitting position, crossing your legs. And if you like, put again your hands on your legs with your palms facing up. And just remind yourself that you have that tool there to practice, yeah, to create more and more connection, to receive the energy that you need any moment of your day. To receive it, and also when you start to feel that energy feel on your hands, You can use it for put it on the different areas of your body to calm yourself or to help with any pain that you can have, yeah? Just to bring this power back to you. Now give a big thanks to yourself for taking the time to come to class. And I thank you for sharing your time and your practice with me.